Hello everybody and welcome to the second lecture of ProEngineer Made Simple. Today I'm going to show you how to make a sketch in ProEngineer. And I'm going to start by making a part. Even though this is a sketch up there that we can make, primarily we're going to be using sketches and parts. And this will come much later. So we're going to make this sketch lesson. We don't have a space in there, and everything's going to be wonderful with ProEngineer accepting the name. Now, this over here in the top right corner is the sketch button. This is how you make a sketch. So if we click on this, it's going to ask you to define a plane to use. And if you simply click on any plane, you can see it highlighted in blue right now. I'm going to select the front datum plane. And I'm going to sketch. Now here we are. This is a 2D image. So we have a Y axis and an X axis. And that's how everything's going to be defined. Now these axes are references. We always want to make sure we have at least two references, or that we're referencing this coordinate system in the middle that you can see, this part C, S, Y, S, D, E, F. So this may look like your standard image making computer tools. We have straight lines, we can make boxes, circles, curves, squiggles, whatever you really want. But what's behind these in the arrows is also important. You can make ovals, you make concentric circles, you can define your ellipses in different ways, you can make different types of curves, all very useful things. Let's start out with a half circle. I'm going to start by making a circle and using the straight line tool to make a line here to cut it in half. Now you notice that we have a lot of extra stuff over here. We're going to want to delete that. So I'm going to use this tool right here, which will delete little things. You can either click on them, or you can click and drag your mouse through multiple items. And now we have our half circle. In order to make it so you can zoom in or out or click on something, always go back to the mouse tool when you're done deleting. It'll save you from having to undo different things. Now in ProEngineer, everything has a dimension to it, whether you make it a certain length or you just say, oh yeah, that looks about right. Everything's going to have a defined length or dimension. In this case, we have 155 units as our radius. So it'll be 155 units from this center point out to the corner or anywhere along this arc. And we can change that. Let's make this 50. And you notice ProEngineer just automatically resized our window. It's very nice like that. Now say we want to add a box or something over here down below. We're going to zoom out and move our part up. And we want this box to meet at this point over here and that point right there and touch. And so I have the straight line tool selected, and you can sort of see that a mouse is catching on that point. That means that it's going to go in that direction. Sorry, it's going to click there. It's going to start at exactly where those two lines meet. And I can drag this down however I want, any angle I want. But let's just start by going directly down. You see this little V here? That means that this line is now vertical. Well, we already know it's vertical. It looks vertical. Well, let's go across. And again, we get a little red dot here because it's trying to select the axis here as the endpoint. And we click that, and you could see that little H pop up. That means it's horizontal. Now we can go all the way back up, select that point, and we're all set. But now we got this line in the middle, and ProEngineer is still thinking that we want to make another line. Well, we can stop that in two ways. We could either skip straight to the delete tool, or we could go to the mouse. But since we just want to delete right now, I'm just going to hit delete and delete that line. Now you notice that we can edit the dimension of this height right here from the x-axis down to this line, but we can't edit how wide this line goes and how wide this box is. That's because it's using this dimension right here, this radius from this point to that point, and it's assuming that we already know that. So I'm going to select that and let's make this 50. Now we have a nice square and a half circle. And I'm going to accept this with the check mark. And there we have our sketch in blue on the front datum plane. Now, say for example, we didn't want this box down here. We wanted it on the other side. Well, we don't have to start all over again. What we can do is go click on this sketch on the left column here, and then go all the way down to edit definition. If we click on that, it brings us right back into the editing mode for the sketch. And I'm going to go ahead and delete the extra lines that we don't want, and start with the straight line tool going from here to here. And again, we don't want to make another line from there, so I'll go to the mouse and then back to the straight line tool. And all of a sudden, no matter how I move my mouse right here, it's snapping to a certain length. Right there, it assumed that we wanted to make this line and this line the same length. And in fact, it gives us L1 and L1, saying that those two lengths are equal. And it's a very useful thing to have there. Now, if you have a lot of different lines, it can get a little hectic, because you have L1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, on and on and on. But for just a simple sketch, it's very useful to have. And we'll accept this again. And there we'll have our sketch in ProEngineer. So go ahead and play around with the different tools. I'll show you a couple more. I'll make another sketch. This time I selected the datum plane first rather than click on the button first. If you click on the datum plane first and then click on the button, it automatically assumes that that is the datum plane that you want to use as your reference, and it'll automatically go in. Now we'll hit sketch here, and I'll make a box this time. I'll start at the center here, and I'll go up. And let's make this 300. And you notice this goes way out, so we're going to zoom out. And let's make this 100. Now compared to our other sketch, which is only about that tall, this is going to be very big. Now let's play around with this tool. This is called the spline tool. And I'm going to start down in this corner. I'm going to click over here. And notice how we create a line that goes through every single point that I click at. It's quite fun to play around with, and you can make some very interesting curves. Now another point that you can snap an end of a line to is the middle point of any line. So right there, I'm snapping to the center of this vertical line up here. And sometimes you'll see a little M where that H is. There we go. There we have our little M. So that indicates that it's at the midpoint between those two points and the midpoint of the line. So let's go ahead and accept this. And you can see, wow, we have a very big sketch compared to what we first made. So continue to play around, have some fun with this, get used to the tools, and I will see you in the next lecture.